good evening. I have said this publicly in several occasions. This plant, you know, rare plant, is really bad plant. I will show you in a minute why we can't accept this plant. As an engineer, as an environmentalist, as a citizen, I think it's quite crucial because I have run very complicated chemical plant. I'm a real engineer. I'm not a paper engineer. I'm not just a paper professor. I run chemical plant. I was activist. Nija was my lawyer when we were arrested under ISA Operation Larang. So I'm going to deal with this. But tonight, I'm just giving you some facts, crucial facts. This is the plant itself. Yeah. From the Google. I think Gavin is here. Hello. Okay. First thing is this, I think I mentioned 66,000 tons. We will import 66,000 tons. We extract 22,000 tons of REO, rare earth oxide. And together with it, we will have 106 tons per year of coal, like 0.16%, 4 tons of uranium. But of course, more important, this thorium is not just thorium, it will decay and it will give us daughters and grandchildren of fission, so you will have radium. And in fact, our biggest concern in this case is not so much thorium, it is the daughter. And then in particular case of Bukit Merah Papan issue, all the radiation comes from radium, actually 80%. And first, I think we got to recognize that there's no safe dose. And when I was in counting, they always harass me. They tell me radiation is safe. I say, okay, yeah. Show me any evidence. If there's evidence that the radiation is safe, I can stay in counting for life. So, but this is not based on my imagination. This comes from US EPA. National Academic Science Report, 1990. I say 1990, which is opposed to the 2005. In fact, this came out before, stating the no threshold of the biological effect of ionizing radiation, but he was removed. Professor Rafferty, he was removed immediately. Like what William talked about. The situation changing of all these guards at the top, you know. So we will come back to that. And then you got a so-called BL7 report in 2005. So we were very lucky we had Rafferty come and tell us. And that's how we become very strong, very sure that we are standing on the right footing. Not only on precautionary principle, but rather the fact that a professor from Harvard can tell us is true. And here's the man. And those who like to smoke, there's a radiation, he discovered polonium 210. If you remember the KGB spy that defected to UK, he was poisoned by this polonium and he died within a few days, very painful. Okay. So he got a radiation level in smoker were typically at least 7 times greater than in non-smoker. This is your lung, how it looks like if you smoke. Quite nice, isn't it? So that's with the reference. The plant of Lynas originally was not belong to Lynas, it belongs to Ashton. The first company that did the study at about $4 billion in 1992. So they compare monazite Australia. In fact, it was imported to Bukit Merah. We ran out of monazite, so we imported. It's very high, 7% thorium, uranium 0.2. Xenotite, Malaysia is 2%, 0.6, but still high. Now, Marwell, the uranium, the thorium is much lower, of course, according to the report, but I've been charging them, show me the independent chemist report. When we met Nicholas Curtis in Sydney, he couldn't show us, even today, he cannot show us, it's true. So this is the plan. Our biggest concern, incidentally, while we met the IAEA expert panel, if you read the report, this is quite a crucial bit that we miss out. The rotary clean actually is to destroy the poisonous surfactant from the oil that is imported from our well. And we are finding out how poisonous it is. But
it will come up as a, if it's not properly run, as a chemical engineer, I better tell you, we do always have operational problem. So you die your business. We do have operational problem. The plant's supposed to run 24 hours a day, 365, you know. But we often have operational problems, okay. So if it's an ordinary chemical plant, I think you're quite all right. But if you have this nasty stuff here, polonium and radioactive lead, oh, so sorry, Taiping. We cannot agree with a plant like that. When you're sleeping, and they will just release into your dream. Sorry about that. That's 650 degrees, really bad. This is pointed out by the IAEA, and their expert report. And we got lots of this equipment here. These are very old ancient technology, which you do, you know, from 2, from 3 size, titration, you remember? That's what they do. Acid dissolving some of this compound and leave some behind, and then you re-dissolve. It's ancient, I told them, it's bloody stupid technology. Sorry, my language. And you can see here, the leach is selective for this, this form, the report itself. Impurity that has to be removed by the solvent extraction of the lead, radium, and barium. It's never reported in the preliminary EIA. This is crucial bit. This crucial bit. It's not just thorium alone, but these the doctors. And then, of course, they are supposed to remove together, and then, well, eventually, in the original action plan was to ship back to Malwell and bury it in the hall. While we say this like happily, thinking it's the way out, I think in Perth, one of the orang original, the Patan or Asli, told us, no, you don't dig my land. You don't put that bloody dirty thing in back my land. So we'll be educated. Our concern is that, of course, the people and also the environment, and also we have potentially a very catastrophic economic problem here. We are looking at 230,000 tons of solid waste containing all these radioactive and minerals. I must point out also, it's important you realize the process is not 100% extraction, it's 90% or so. So you are left with 10% of rare earth minerals in the solid. And I won't show it here, those of us are on the our circulation. Recently, China had found rare earth minerals in tea, oolong tea and Lipton, Tea Kwan Yin tea. Throw them out, you got them from China now. So this is good news for rare earth mineral. In fact, our friends in the Bukit Merah who helped to transport the waste and dispose of the waste, he reported very large growth of plants, you know, when supply with the rare earth waste. So be very careful. We have 50,500 tons of clean water every hour. 90,000 cubic, what you call, gas. You know, so if you look at this in 30 years, yearly, you can see here radioactive waste is about 7 million tons. If you run 40 years, then of course you will have about, another 10 years, another 3 maybe. So you got about 10 million tons. And 10 million tons in Malaysia, any of this waste going to Kuala Alam, toxic waste disposal is $3,000 a ton today. So we're looking at about 20 billion, billion. So the issue here is 20 billion issue. So we're talking big money. This is big. Big on the people's pocket. If they have no money to do this, like now in the Bukit Merah, they claim they spend $100 million to deal with the waste. But we have to sacrifice 40 hectares of virgin land for them. So I estimate for one ton's plant, you will be around 1,000 hectare. I don't know where you're going to get that thing. And also, we're going to use a lot of clean virgin water to bathe all this dirty radioactive substance. So you have 20 million ton water, you know, molested water. Okay? Gaseous particulate, this is unimaginable. It's a huge amount. I have done quite a lot of calculation designing chimney, you know, set disposal for toxic gas, you know, by dilution, which is quite an immoral act, actually. So, but I haven't seen such a huge number before. This is really shocking and appalling. So again, you know, you look at the clean water they use, 120 million tons. I think Kuantan potentially will be competing, the rest will be competing with the plant for clean water, I think. And then acid, they use hell of acid. they're going to import acid and they're going to produce it in Kuantan. So you're going to get a lot of acid fumes. Kuantan folks, sorry about that. You know, any chemical plant, when they are operating properly, you look at 99.99% maybe production, you know, what do you call reliability, you always get about 0.001% problem. So you're going to get intermittently some of these acid fumes. So you probably may have quite a bit of asthma, I think. Quite a bit of asthma. Those living in Mitulu will tell you, the children have a big incidence of asthma and a lot of alkali, a lot of hell of chemicals. Terrible. I mean, you're producing only 22,000 tons of materials and you use how much yearly, you produce quarter million tons of waste, you know, just to produce them. 20,000 tons of material, and he uses such a huge amount of material. It's really, really appalling, you know. So it also, we calculate the gas, you know, the electricity, and the carbon. I mean, they also, landers coming to Malaysia would not have to pay the carbon tax in Australia. So there's kind of a, what do you call, criminal act, I think. So, this is the 21 billion I talked about in 30 years, if you have to ship this to Quality Alam. So in the land also. So I think the ultimate issue for us is this. If you accept it, if Kai Peng say, okay, you want rare earth plant, never mind. But I'd like to ask you, what's their plan for the waste treatment? What is their plan? I mean, to do a waste treatment plant, you would need to have a proper detailed EIA. The so-called EIA just now being mentioned is just preliminary. It's not a detailed EIA. It's the one that whitewashed any application. I've done two or three. I find very immoral. I've stopped that. It's horrible. Because any project you take up, you have to say yes to it. You cannot say, I disagree with the project. So sorry about that. So what's the cost? This is huge. Okay? Billions. Who will foot the bill if Linus pull out suddenly overnight? Okay? And you check the owner shareholder of Linus today, we pay $1,000 for it. We only see, nominees. Last week, this week we have a good laugh because One China National told one of our friends that they bought a few million dollars share. And they were worried how come this share of all the mining share in Australia always go up. Now it dropped from $2 to $1.20. So what is the funding plan for all this cost, $30 billion. Emergency plan, decommissioning, funding. And this one is raised also by the IAEA report. And I suppose one of the things we don't quite like about all this, because we've been dealing with all this problem from overseas. Companies just come in, they think they're doing a good job for us, giving us money. We don't see any good work up to now, I think this is a problem. Tax holiday for them. How many of you get tax holiday in this country? I'm almost a retiree now. I never get any discount from the tax. But here he brought us $30 billion worth of waste, toxic waste, and we are going to pay for it. So folks, so disaster scenario, one of them, somebody asked me what possibly could happen to the waste dump or the factory. So contamination, chronic exposure, sea resources, marine resources, and also economic crops. So this is the fishing village. I think this is about all. It's a good life in Kuantan, near Kuantan. Aslan, sorry. It's going to come. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Tan. Expert. Always frightening.